Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Jimmy and the Pulsating Mass. In the last episode, we made it to the end of the TV world and we fought Jonathan Baer and we died. But in this episode, I think it's going to go a little bit different this time. I didn't do any grinding, but I did think about what I did in the last episode and I realized one crucial mistake I made, which was to go all out ham on him at the very beginning of the match. You should save your heavy hitters for when he enters his more dangerous phases. So we're going to try this again here, and I hope that this strategy actually works. Another thing that I did wrong in the last episode was that I did not save my insults. Jonathan Baer is fast, so it's a better idea in this fight to wait, to not try to startle him to cause him to waste turns, but rather save your insults for when he grasps you in his mouth, so that he can't instantly kill you. That's a better way to do it. Okay, that was good. I didn't switch out Ghostfire. Dang it! I forgot to do that between episodes, before I started the fight. I wonder if it might actually be worth switching over to the flower just so I can have more healing. Oh, well, what would be really nice would be if I had, like... Okay, I'm gonna use Sticky Phlegm. I am gonna do that. You're gonna use, yeah, I'll use Mag Combo, you know, whatever. As long as I don't... I just wanna make sure I have enough to do Reckless Charge, and I wanna save Master Criminal for late in the fight, so that we can use it then to more... die for fly to better handle his later phases. Yeah, 68 damage, that's not that much damage. I would have done more to Helga, would have done a lot more to Jimmy right now, but you know what, I probably shouldn't have turned into the sunflower. What I probably should have done instead was turn into the bear, except I'd have that I have that weapon equipped that gives me more offense, so I don't know if that would actually be that such a good idea. Helga, you can just keep plugging away with those rad sneakers. It's not that strong. It might be time for an upgrade. Not necessarily an upgrade, more like a lateral grade, because a weapon that increases your agility by 250 is always going to be useful. It's just a matter of whether or not that agility is worth a lowered offense, in almost every case, the answer to that question is yes. Okay, switch over to the bird so that we can squawk and distract him. I didn't need to do that. I could have used the Roman Candle. I don't know how I feel about using, like... The biggest issue for me in the early parts of this fight now is that I'm worried about wasting my MP, you know? That should do. I wish there was more for me to say, but I think I kind of blew my stack on all the things I like about this boss fight in the last part. Like how there's no background, it's just black. This is the only fight in the game that does that, I think. There are optional areas later that have... Oh, no, you know what? The cave in the Whisper Weaver's Den. Oops, that's a spoiler. The cave in the giant garden, that also has no background. Yeah. You know what, just attack. We're fine. What did I have Buck do even? Ow, diseased claws. I think we're all immune to sick, which is nice. Yeah, I think I might switch to the pumpkin. Because if I switch to the pumpkin, then I can use my most powerful magic attacks. Well, the Black Fountain is more powerful than Ghostfire. But Black Fountain does, but Ghostfire doesn't have a cooldown, so. Now you might say, oh, well, in that case, you know, it's objectively better to use a move that you can use every turn for the maximum amount of DPS, but the thing is, the problem with that way of thinking is that you don't get a chance to attack every single turn, because there's damage control you need to do, you know? Okay, well, that's the last one of those, because I want to save my MP so that he can use Pulverizing Light later in the fight. Between Reckless Charge and stealing the stuffing out of this guy, we should be able to, you just use Pulp Rider Light, we should be fine. Between Reckless Charge and stealing Stitching, oh, what are you doing? What do you think you're doing? What is it exactly that you think you're doing? Okay, you just use Ghost Fire again, and you use, Roman Candle. Man, that's got increased priority, definitely, because there's no way anything should be outspeeding Helga. Yeah, because he enters his second phase when he hits 40% of his health, and he's right about at that threshold now. I think I'm actually going to take some time here to use a couple of these on Buck. You're going to use Comforting Smile, yeah. Jimmy can knock him down beneath 40% HP. I don't remember if there's like a line, if there's special dialogue when he hits that threshold. Does that look like 40% to you? I don't know. Yeah. Ghost Fire. Well, I don't know. His skin was writhing and twitching, so I'm a little bit afraid. Charge doing a flurry of sharp T. Thank you for spreading that out evenly. That was very nice of you. Okay, use mag combo. Now after that Choco Cola, he's got enough MP to use each of his powerful moves once, which is nice.
You'll use pulverizing light again.
Staggers backwards and screeches. There you go. That's when he enters his second phase. Yeah, now he's gonna be. I think he might actually get two turns. Now is when we use Mana Burn, we use Ghost Fire, we use the Ghost Beach, we use Pulverizing Light, you use High Five on yourself to keep yourself alive because you don't want to die. That's going to hurt like hell. Skin writhes and twitches, your fist is filled with righteous indignation, and you're totally out of MP, which means I think I'm going to switch over to the Vampire, just because it has a little bit more defense. And you're gonna guard. You're gonna use Reckless Charge. I don't care, it doesn't matter. And you are gonna use Master Criminal, steal his stitching. This should finish him off. Ah, the pain! Oh! Oh, jeez. Ow, ow, ow. Yeah, that'll do it. Boom! See you later, Jonathan Bear. 4,500 experience. Damn, that's impressive. Skip. Oh, fuck. Hang on. Shit. Fuck. Shit. Click.
Why am I rotting inside? The pulsating mass promised me more time. Jimmy, we can still be friends. If you'll just come with me.
Whoa! Buck! No! Ah! Buck! Oh, she just runs after him. Oh, man, what a badass. Gee, what the... Oh, God. Oh, no.
Today's a special day. Do you know why? It's another day I can spend with you.
Ew.
Today's a special day. Do you know why? It's another day I can spend with you!
Ugh.
Today's a special day. Do you know why? It's another day I can spend with you! Let's play a game. If you wake up, I'll stop crying.
Huh? What the hell? Where am I? What? Buck's equipment has been removed! Oh, jeez, so he really is gone then, huh? Oh my gosh, I have nobody.
Everyone's gone!
Oh, hey, there's Helga. And she's lying on the floor. Well, I don't know. Should I? I feel like it would be really awkward to continue after this. I think we might have to wait until next time. We might have two short dick videos today that go up in tandem with each other. Just like 20 minutes of me fighting Jonathan Bear. You know what? That sounds like a day to me. So, next time on Game Grumps, we'll find out what's hurting so bad. Which is to say, next time with Jimmy and the Pulsating Mass, we'll figure out why Helga's in a funk. And also where the hell we are that looks like that looks like some kind of, like, not really 8-bit, it's just like everything is like smaller pixels scaled up so it looks really blocky. Kind of like 8-bit, like, it's like, it reminds me of like Realm of the Mad, holy cow, you hear that throat sound, that, jeez. It's like Realm of the Mad God or like 3D Game Heroes or something. I know 3D Game Heroes doesn't look like this, but it kind of reminds me of it. Anyway, bye!